Welcome everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. This week we are going to do this double color exposure effect. We're going to use the colors red and cyan. So as usual, let's get started. Going to start over here with the picture of our model and simply just Command C to start with. Come over here to the picture of our city of New York and Command V. Grab our move tool and just resize the picture of our model here to fit all the way over the city, and let's reduce that opacity a little bit so we can see all the way through. I'm going to make my picture a little bit smaller now using my command minus, and I'm just going to make that picture of the model a little bit bigger just to position her in the spot that I would like her to be. Also going to come to the background here and unlock the background, and I'm going to resize that as well. You can position this anywhere you like. I'm just going to go probably about there, looks pretty good, and make the picture a little bit bigger again with my command plus. Okay, back on the background, let's bring the opacity all the way back up and let's name the background model and hit enter. And the background of the city, let's name that one city. Now we're going to set all our adjustments and layers up right from the start. So on the model layer here, let's go Command G and create a group, and let's call that group the red group. And on the city here, let's do the same thing, Command G, and let's call that the cyan group. They're the two colors we're going to use for this picture today. So onto the red group, let's open that up, let's right click on that and make it red. And on the cyan group, let's right click on that and make it sort of blue to represent the cyan. So now we've got a red group and a cyan group. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do to set all this up is we're going to add a new fill layer to each of these groups. So we'll go layer, new fill layer, and we're just going to clip that underneath there. Let's do the same to the cyan group as well. Layer, new fill layer, and let's clip that under there. Okay, the next adjustment that we're going to add is an exposure. So let's grab an exposure, and we're just going to put that underneath the fill and above the model. And the next one we're going to do is a black and white, and we're going to put that in between the exposure and the model. Okay, we're going to do the same for the cyan group. So we'll grab an exposure, we'll bring that one down underneath the color, and we'll grab a black and white as well, and we'll put that one in between. Okay, so we've got our groups set up now, so that's looking pretty good. Got our red group, and we've got our cyan group. So let's start with the red group first. Let's click on our fill layer in our red group. We'll come over here to our colors. I'm gonna use the swatches, and I'm gonna pick the color red. I'm going to change the blend mode of this color to color down here underneath saturation. We're going to do the same for the fill layer here in the cyan group. We're going to change that color, you guessed it, to cyan. And you can't see anything happen there, but if I turn this red group off, you'll see that it's gone cyan. And I'll change the blend mode to color. And again, if I turn this off, you can see now the city has got that cyan color overlaid on the top. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Let's click on the red group here, the actual group layer, and let's change the blend mode to lighten. Now you'll see our model and the city coming through underneath. And this is where we can now play with the exposure and the black and white adjustment levels to get the look that we're after. So I'm going to start off with the exposure level here, just double click to bring up the little box, and we can start playing with that to bring back some detail in the reds there. And on the black and white, we can now play with the reds and all these other colors as well to bring back some detail. Bring up some of that cyan and the blue here to bring some details back into the hair there, and a little bit of detail there. Okay, let's do the same down here on the cyan group. Let's play with the exposure, looking pretty good. Black and whites, dull that red down a little bit. And you can adjust all these levels to get the look that you're after. It's just a matter of taste now to where you would like to see this picture go. Let's bring those blues up and just keep going until you're happy with what you're seeing here on this picture. I might bring that down a little bit. One thing I might just do on this black and white layer here in the red group is just grab my paintbrush over here. Let's get the colors back to default, hitting D on the keyboard. I'm just going to paint in black. It's going to bring the picture up a little bit bigger, and 100% for opacity, 100% for flow, 0% hardness. And I'm just going to paint over the eyes a little bit just to bring a little bit more detail back out on those eyes. And the other thing I might do is just reposition my model layer here a little bit, bringing that up a little bit so I can see those eyes a bit better. Just about there. Let's bring the picture up a little bit bigger now. And I'm pretty happy with that at the moment. That looks pretty good. The last thing I'm going to do is add my text, which I'm just going to come onto the text layer over here. Click on here and type in New York. And just resize that bit all the way across the picture here. And just move it down a little bit about there. I'm going to move my text layer into the middle of both of these here. Make sure I'm clicked on that. I'm going to come up here to my text and show character. I'm going to highlight my text here. Just make sure I'm on that text layer. And come here to the colors. And I'm going to change it to white. So I've got white text. And you can change the font and the size of bold or italic here to whatever you like. I'm just going to make it bold. I'm going to click off that. On my text layer here, I'm going to come down here to layer effects. I'm going to add an outer shadow. I'm going to turn the radius all the way up and the offset up quite a bit, and a little bit of intensity as well. And then we can just move that around to give that text a little bit more depth. And we're just going to click off that. So there we go. The last thing I might do just on this text layer, might just drop the opacity just so that fades into the picture a little bit. Okay, I am happy with that. So there we go, everybody. That is the double exposure effect in Affinity Photo using the colors of cyan and red. I think it's a pretty cool effect. So I hope you like the tutorial this week. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. And until next time, I'll say to you, stay well, be safe, and I'll see you in the next video.